So carbocation is the same thing. It's the same kind of the example where the thirst has been developed. The thirst has been generated. Now it is craving for water. It says, please sir, give me as much water as you have because I need it now. You understand the importance of water only when you are in desert. You won't understand this once you are in the pristine, you know, pristine area like Kangal, where you have got the rivulets, you have got streams, you have got rivers of water. You come to senses only when you are in a desert, and that too in the midst of the day, in the broad daylight, when you are sweating like anything. Then you feel the thirst, and then you start looking at some animal, some anything, but whatever comes your way. Even if there is some cesspool somewhere where there is a dirty water, you will simply plunge into it to have a sip taken. Because we have never realized the thirst. Believe me, all of us being in Kashmir, we have never realized and felt the thirst, what the thirst means. Because Allah has given us what? A bounty in the form of, yes, we have got oceans of, you know, sources of water here in Kashmir. So we never realize the thirst. Please talk to the persons who are in the desert, who are the devilers of desert. They come to know about the thirst when it is the midst of the day, it is the middle of the day, there is no water source. And then when they start feeling the thirst, what they feel like, please ask them. Okay, so I have developed the thirst over here. Now the water comes. Earlier, water was not even touching it. But now having made this as what? A carbocation, water says, please show me where it is. I'll simply go and drop myself on it. So water goes, attacks on this. You see, my dear friends, water has got a lone pair of electrons. What? Please talk with one voice. So this lone pair of electrons attacks on the carbocation, and we have the formation of what? CH2 is now making a bond with the oxygen of water. So two hydrogens are there with the water. So now we can see that the electron pair, the electron pair of the oxygen of water has been utilized to make a bond with the carbocation. A sigma bond is made. Now, having given the electron pair to what? The carbocation, the oxygen here, what will it be? It will be a positive charge. If I have made your pain bad, if I have made your pain bad, then I have made your pain bad. How? If you have made your pain bad, then it goes on your own pain. So here you can see that the carbocation pain, the positive charge, it was finished, but the positive charge is on the oxygen. And you can see now, we have to neutralize this oxygen. This oxygen has to be neutralized, its positive charge has to be vanished. So one of the two hydrogens takes a leave, and electron pair of it goes to the oxygen, and we have the formation of CH2OH CH3 plus H positive is given out. This is called the alcohol. This is called alcohol, and specific name is ethanol. This is the mechanism of this. The first step is the addition of H positive from the acid. Okay? Okay? Later we have the formation of the carbocation, and then the carbocation, it does not shake hand. It does not shake hand with the water. It simply embraces water. It embraces water. It does not shake only its hands, but it simply embraces it and encapsulates the carbocation, and then we have the formation of the ethanol. Now the case is, if you have a kind of alkene, very important, before I switch off my phone, because I want my lectures very short so that the people could see them, because once we are having a long lecture, a long duration lecture, it basically goes almost around for 3 GBs or for 2 GBs. So people don't love to see it because they don't basically want to, you know, exhaust their recharge or exhaust their, data. Now we have got one more. Now friends, help yourself to understand this thing. What kind of alkene is this? Unsymmetrical alkene. What?
Unsymmetrical alkene.
And here we have got a double bond. Now, if you perform its reaction with water in the presence of H+O2-, so what would you do? Should you put this H with this carbon or with this carbon? Because here you have got a difference. In the earlier example, you had got no difference. Either you would go to the right carbon or to the left carbon, would have made no difference. But in this case, we have got what? Two different types of carbon. So you have now a choice to go to. So this type of confusion is resolved by Balkonikov's rule. What?
Balkonikov's
rule says that the H positive or the positively charged part will go to that carbon which has got more number of hydrogens. More number of?
Hydrogen.
Please help me to understand this, friends. Out of these two carbons, which carbon has more number of hydrogens? The right one. So Balkonikov's rule says this electron pair will shift towards this and it will take up the hydrogen. So it will go to that carbon which contains more number of hydrogens. Now the formation of CH3, CH, single bond CH3 now. It becomes CH3 now because having added one H positive by spending electron pair from it. Now this middle carbon develops what? A positive charge. It is a 2 degree carbocation, friends. What? Help me to understand this. 2 degree? 2 degree carbocation. Then the water does not shake hands but embraces it. It cuddles. What? The word is cuddle. Cuddle means to have someone in your arms. Cuddle. Embrace. It cuddles water. It is the same water. Who would say, please, I can sip it on this alkene. I hate alkene. Alkene was saying, I spit on water. I hate water. But once I have made the alkene a carbocation, water says, no, it's my sweetheart now. It's my
sweetheart.
Because I have developed that craving of the carbocation for water. I have made a carbocation which is very unstable. It has got a huge amount of thirst. It wants the water not to come and shake hands, but to come and cuddle. And cuddle means to embrace. So water comes now, my dear friends. Water has got one pair of electrons, attacks on the carbocation, formation of CH3, CH, CH3. Now water has made a bond with the carbocation, but having now developed a positive charge on its own head, then this positive charge gets neutralized by releasing one H positive, and we have the formation of a compound, an alcohol that's called as a 2 degree alcohol, my dear friends. We can call this alcohol as butyl 2-ol. It's a 2 degree alcohol. What?
2 degree.
Yesterday, please remember and recall, I gave you the account of 1 degree, 2 degree, and 3 degree alcohol. And so, this is basically a 2 degree alcohol. The 2 degree alcohol is formed in major amount wherever you have got an unsymmetrical alkene like this. Sure? With these words, friends, I take you a leave. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.